Welcome, everyone. Here is a conversation that I had with a colleague about a better way to do the speed dating activity with ESL students.
David, I've been curious about the speed dating activity, so I researched it online and watched some videos on YouTube. In it, pairs of students are matched up and interview each other to see if they'd like to have a date. You know, if I were an ESL student, I think this would be kind of an embarrassing experience for several reasons. I really wouldn't want to talk about myself and try to impress my classmate, and I wouldn't want to have to tell them that I'd like to have a date or not have a date with them. So, you know, these sites and the videos that I visited didn't have students actually say whether they'd want to have a date at the end, which kind of ruined the final point of the whole activity. Have you ever done this activity?
Yeah, but I did it completely differently. The way I did this eliminated the problem with students feeling embarrassed either during the interview or at the end. And this is a way that you can free up your students to use their imagination. They can expand what they can say, and it relieves the pressure of trying to impress their partner. And due to the culminating step, it also gives the questioners a reason to actually listen to their responses.
Oh, that sounds good. So how did you do it?
Well, I started by telling them what speed dating was. For example, I said that in a room, there are, say, 12 people. Everyone is matched up with a partner, and they talk to each other for, you know, about 5 minutes and try to decide if they'd like to have a date after class. Then they rotate to a new partner and do the same. And this process continues for maybe 3 or 4, 5 rounds. Then I say that we're going to do this speed dating in our class, but each of them is going to be a pretend person. So I show them, either on paper or on a screen, some pictures of people, and it looks kind of like this. Then I tell them that each of them will choose one of the pictures, and they will imagine that they are that person. I give them a few minutes to think about their new personalities and their new biography. Actually, sometimes I've given them a day to think about their new personality and then do the activity the next day in class. Then I put half of them in a circle facing out and half in a circle facing in. And they are matched with a partner. They interview each other using their new personalities for several minutes, you know, say 5 minutes or so. And then I tell them to stop. Then I ask them to write on a piece of paper, yes or no, meaning yes, I would date this person, or no, I would not. And then they tell each other their decision and why.
Interesting. So because they are an imaginary person, they wouldn't feel embarrassed if they are rejected. And they won't feel like they should say that they want a date because they know they won't hurt that person's feelings.
Exactly. And they have to explain why they want or don't want a date. In order to do this, they have to actually have been listening to each other. I usually hear a lot of laughing during this.
Great. And then they talk to a new partner?
Right. The students on the outside circle rotate 1 seat clockwise. I tell them that they can continue with the picture and personality from the first round, or they can change to a different one if they'd like.
So, like, what kind of questions do they ask?
Well, to make it more interesting and creative, it's best if they don't just ask biographical questions like, what's your job, or do you have any kids? So I like to give them a list of questions that they can choose from, but I also tell them that they can ask their own questions too. And here are some sample questions that I've used. I'll just read a couple here. So, if I gave you a plane ticket to any place, where would you go? Or why do you think your best friends like you? Another one. What would you do if your neighbor's dog kept you awake because it was barking all night? So, in the notes below, I'll give a link where you can find these questions. Also, notice at the end of this list, I include a place where they can ask their own questions. I also make sure that they understand they can choose any of these questions and they can ask them in any order that they want.
Yeah, these sound very good. I can see how these would be more interesting and fun to talk about. We'd get a pretty good idea of the other person's personality through these.
Right. And there is one more step before starting the activity. We want to present a model of how they can best do this activity. This model will demonstrate how they should, you know, use their imagination and how they should respond with rejoinders, which is a conversation skill that they're going to use even outside of class, and also how they should ask follow-up questions. And then, you know, for higher level students, we can show them how they should answer with details, another good conversation skill. So here is how you can model speed dating. So you're going to put a picture of two different people on the screen, or it can be on paper, for the students, all the students to see. Now, before actually doing this modeling in advance, you're going to write a short speed dating dialogue between these two people that are everybody's going to look at. And then in class, you put the picture on the screen and then choose a student to read one of the dialogue parts, and the teacher will read the other part to the whole class. So here's an example of what I would show. This is what they, all they're going to see is the picture of those two student, person A and person B. They're not going to see, the students aren't going to see, other than the student that's reading with me. They're not going to see this dialogue. They just have to listen.
Okay, let's read it. You can be the teacher, okay?
Sure. So when they start the activity, we want the students to start by telling their partner which picture they are and their pretend name. So I start by saying, I'm picture B. Hi, my name is Brad.
I'm picture A. Hi, Brad. I'm Amy.
Hi, Amy. Why do you think your best friends like you?
Well, let's see. Probably because I'm pretty famous. Maybe you've seen me on YouTube.
Whoa. No, I'm sorry. I've never seen your videos. What are your videos about?
I try to do dangerous tricks like standing on a horse while it's running.
Oh, I like women who do dangerous things.
Brad, tell me about something nice that you've done.
Actually, I did something nice just before this picture of me was taken. I saw this homeless guy on the street, and he looked really cold, so I gave him my shirt.
Oh, that's wonderful. Do you often help homeless people?
So our conversation will continue for several minutes. The dialogue would continue. And then I would explain to them that they should use their imagination, like in this dialogue, when Amy said that she is famous. And I want them to make sure they use rejoinders like, wow, and that's wonderful. And they should ask follow-up questions like, what are your videos about? And do you often help homeless people?
Cool. So at this point, they should be all ready to start the activity. And all I do as the teacher is keep track of the time and tell them when to stop and then tell them to write yes and no on their paper and then show it to their partner and briefly explain why they would like to have a date or not. Then after they've done that, I tell the people on the outside circle to stand up and rotate one seat clockwise. Have I got it right?
Yes, you do. I'm going to put a link in the notes below where viewers can go to read about all this, including the directions that you just said. I'll also include links to other videos about better ways to do other popular ESL activities. So, thank you for watching.